Okay. After a long time, since we have not met before the internals, today I am going to discuss one of the important problem. Okay, that is nothing but page rank problem. Guys, this problem has been similar to this problem. Okay, similar to this, I am saying the same, not a problem, has been asked in the previous year exam question paper. It was the last question. But believe me, it is the easiest question to score good marks. Okay. So what they are going to do is, okay, first and foremost thing, they are going to give you a graph where every node is going to be acting like a page. And you know what is a hub and what is the authority in the previous class, if you remember. I have uploaded the same video to even YouTube. Okay. So this is what the problem I have solved, and let me teach you. After solving this problem, in tomorrow's class we are going to see the old previous year question paper, and let me show you whatever the topics I have did, everything is there in the previous year question paper. Okay, so even the problems which you have solved in your internals, even that was also there. Okay, so with this, let me start today's class. So what they are going to do is they are going to give us a graph, and they are going to tell us how much iterations we have to do, and decide based on the iterations we have to find out the page rank. Okay, so here they have given the four nodes. Okay, A is pointing towards B. Okay, and C is pointing towards A. Don't consider it's a bi-direction, it's a one direction, sorry. Okay. And C is pointing towards B, and B is pointing towards D. And you know what is the meaning of incoming and outgoing nodes very, very well. Okay. So what we need to do is, here they have asked us to do the three iterations. Based on the three iterations, we have to decide which page is going to have a good ranking, page ranking in a web mining especially. Page rank differs from algorithm to algorithm, but here we are discussing basically page rank in web mining. And in the previous classes, you have studied already what is the meaning of a web mining. Okay, so with this, let us. What you need to do is first you need to prepare a chart to decide, okay, which is the page which is having highest number of the hits, so that we can decide which page is going to be the number one in the number of pages. So here A is one page, B is one page, C is one page, D is one page, where we are having hyperlink from A to B, or we are. That is what I told you. It is something like a hub and authority. Okay, you know what is the meaning of a hub in the previous classes, and what is the authority in degree and out degree? That is nothing but hub and authority. Okay, so first you need to plot a graph with number of nodes. Believe me, here there is only four nodes. If there was a five nodes, A B C D E. If there are six nodes, A B C D E F. Okay, and number of iterations which is going to be assigned to you in the problem statement. Here I have taken only three iterations. Okay, so iteration 0, iteration 1, and iteration 2. So what we need to do is we need to calculate the iterations with a formula. Okay, PR indicates previous iteration. Okay, it is a formula, PR of I plus 1 of P1, which is equal to summation of PI. Okay, where PR I of PJ divided by C of PJ. Nothing to worry more. It is very, very simple. It says this: I need to calculate the page rank of for the next iteration. Always I need to calculate the page rank for the next iteration. See, this is the first iteration, zero iteration, first iteration, second iteration. So what I need to do, by default, the iteration of zero will be 1 divided by n. N indicates number of nodes. Since I am having how many nodes, you can see very clearly, I am having four nodes. 1, 2, 3, 4. So 1 divided by 4. Instead of saying the first iteration, we are going to say a zeroth iteration is all 1 by 4 for all the nodes. That is nothing but 1 divided by n. If there was 5 nodes, 1 divided by 5. If there are 6 nodes, 1 divided by 6. This is our zeroth iteration. Okay, so now we need to calculate the next iteration. Next iteration is iteration 1. For every node, we need to calculate the iteration. For that, the formula is very clear. Page rank for next iteration. Can you just hold for a second? Let me add the pointer. Okay, pointer, pointer. Where is my pointer? Where is my? I got presentation pointer. Okay, activate. Oh, okay, fine. Can you see now? Fine. Page rank for next iteration is equal to, okay, first what we need to do on the numerator, page rank of the given site in the previous iteration, page rank of the given site in the previous iteration divided by total number of outgoing links. This is very, very important. This is quite common. Page rank for what we are doing, we got 0th iteration by default. Whenever you are solving the problem, the 0th iteration is nothing but 1 divided by n. N is nothing but number of nodes. Instead of saying number of nodes, I can say number of pages because we are dealing with page rank. Here, every node is nothing but a page. Okay. So now 1 divided by, since there are 4 nodes, it is 1 divided by 4. 1 divided by 4 is nothing but equal to 1 divided by n. So by default, every iteration of all the nodes will be 0. Okay. Zero. Can you see this? Zero. Zero iteration is 1 divided by 4, 1 divided by 4, 1 divided by 4, and 1 divided by 4. So if you sum and again do it all, you can see the output will be 1 by default. Again, you do all the cumulative, the output will be 1. That's how you are going to check the correctness of working. Okay. So what is the formula? Formula you should never forget. Page rank for next iteration is equal to page rank of the given site in previous iteration. That is very, very important. Page rank of given site in previous iteration divided by, this is again very, very important, total number of outgoing links. Outgoing links, you should never forget, outgoing links. So this is what, let us take for the node A. Okay, so taking this for the node A, what are the nodes pointing to A? That is C. Can you see? C is the node which is pointing to A. And no other node is pointing to A. So we need to do the iteration between A and C. Okay. So when we are doing the iteration between A and C, so what is the formula? The formula says very clearly that page rank of the given site in the previous iteration divided by total number of outgoing links. So now, you know, the in degree of A is, the A is getting income by C. Okay. The A is getting income by C. So now what we can see, C is pointing towards A. So we need to do the iteration between A and C. Okay, guys. So what we are going to do, okay, people can see number of page rank of the given site in the previous iteration. What is the page rank of given site in the previous iteration? What is the page rank of A? 1 divided by 4 divided by total number of outgoing links. Can you find out what are the total number of outgoing links from the C? Because C is pointing towards A. Okay. So 1, 2, and 3. Okay. So 1 divided by 4 divided by 3. That is nothing but 1 divided by 12. Okay, page rank of next iteration is 1 divided by 2. So number of outgoing links as per C is concerned is 3. Okay, now let us calculate for B. If you do iteration 1, then you easily do iteration 2. Okay, let us calculate for iteration B. Now you tell me, okay, what is the iteration B says? Iteration B says very clearly that, can you say which node is pointing towards B? Which node is pointing towards B? Like for A, C was pointing. For B, who is pointing? A. Okay. So now let us calculate. Okay. What was the previous iteration of B? Again, same. 1 divided by 4. Okay. 1 divided by 4. Divided by total number of incoming nodes for A. How many nodes? This one is 1. Okay, from here again it is going. Okay, this is one. 2. Okay, 2. Plus. Again, we are having one more incoming. Okay, that is by C. C is also pointing towards B. There are two nodes which is pointing to B. In the previous case, there was only one node which is pointing to A. That is C. Okay, so are you understanding? You should understand, it's very easy, not difficult. Don't get confused. If you get confused, I'm going to solve again, not a problem. Don't worry. Okay. So, yeah.
question is very clear. We need to find total number of outgoing links in the denominator, and we need to find the page rank of the given site in the previous iteration. So here there was only one node pointing towards A, that is C. So what we did, what is the previous iteration of C? 1 divided by 4 divided by total outgoing from the C. 1, 2, 3. Okay, so we have written 3. Now when I come for B, how many nodes are pointing towards B? Two nodes are pointing towards B. Which are those two nodes? A and C. So what will be the output? The output will be sum of two, A and C. So what is the result of A in the previous iteration? 1 divided by 4. Don't say 1 divided by 12. It is 0th iteration. We are trying to calculate iteration 1. So 1 divided by 4 divided by how many incomings for A? 1. Okay. 1. How many outgoings? Outgoings. Sorry. Total number of outgoings. How many total number of outgoings for A? 2. Okay, here 1, here 2. So divided by 2 plus. What is the previous iteration of C? The previous iteration of C is 1 divided by 4 divided by total outgoing of C. What is the total outgoing of C? You know already what is the total outgoing of C. It's 3. 1, 2, 3. So what is the result I got when I do LCM and all? 2.5 divided by 12. Okay. Now you will understand when you do C. Okay, how many incoming nodes towards C? How many nodes pointing towards C? That is A and D. Right, guys? A is pointing towards C and D is pointing towards C. So now what happens? Okay, what is the previous iteration of A? You know it very well. 1 divided by 4 divided by 2. Why 2? 2 outgoings. A towards B and A towards C. Plus, what is the previous iteration of D? The D's previous iteration is 1 divided by 4. What is the total number of outgoing from D? Can you see in the graph? Only 1 towards C, outgoing. Only 1. So, divided by 1. Which is nothing but 4.5 divided by 12. This is 4.5 divided by 12. Okay. So, now, let us take for D. Is any node is pointing towards D? Yes, that is B and C. Okay, B and C. So what is the previous iteration of B? Again, same 1 divided by 4. And total outgoings from B is only 1. Can you check out? Total outgoing from B is only 1. So 1 divided by 4 divided by 1. Similarly, what is the total, iteration of D, previous iteration of D? Again, 1 divided by 4 and total outgoing of D is 1. So 1 divided by 4 divided by 1. So what I got is 4 divided by 12. So I have entered all the results. When I do the computation, I got for A 1 divided by 12. When I do the computation for B, I got 2.5 divided by 12. When I did computation for C, I got 4.5 divided by 12. When I did the computation for D, I got 4 divided by 12. So let us move to the next iteration. You believe me, sir, restore iterations beka how do yake andre in the exam paper in the last semester they have asked for 8 iterations. As the number of iterations grow, the efficiency of getting page rank will be more. You believe me, even there was no notes. I will show you the question and you people need to solve this. Even the notes are more and iterations are 8. Where I have stopped for 3 iterations here. So let us go for page rank 2. Okay, page rank 2 of A. Again, the same thing follows. When I say A, okay, who is pointing towards A? C. C is pointing towards A. Okay, no other node is pointing towards A. So I need to do the iteration with respect to C. So what is the previous iteration of C? Can you check out what is the previous iteration of C? 4.5, iteration 1, 4.5 divided by 12. So write it, 4.5 divided by 12. So total outgoing from C. How many total outgoing from C? 1, 2, okay, where is one more? 3. 1, 2, 3. So 4.5 divided by 12 divided by 3, which I am going to get 1.5 divided by 12. Okay, 1.5 divided by 12. So write it down, 1.5 divided by 12. Okay, so now similarly, page rank of B, again you see who are all pointing towards B. A is pointing towards B, C is pointing towards B. So first let us take what is the page rank of A, previous rank of A, 1 divided by 12. Total outgoing of A, 1 divided by 12 divided by 2. Where are the total outgoing of A? 1, 2, plus, which is the one more node pointing towards B, C. So what is the previous iteration of C? 4.5 divided by 12, and total outgoing from C is 3. You know very well. Sir, hege 3? Il nodi. 1, 2, 3. So 4.5 divided by 12 divided by 3. So what I got after doing LCM and all? 2 divided by 12. It's a simple mathematics. Don't send me again to do this also. Okay, you people can do it. 2 divided by 12. So now, go for C. Iteration 2. Which are the nodes pointing towards C? There are two nodes pointing towards C. Yavdu? Undu A, inundu D. So A the previous iteration divided by outgoing. Mathe D the previous iteration divided by outgoing will get you C. So hege madadu? Il nodi. A. What is the previous iteration of A? 1 divided by 12. What's the outgoing of A? 2. 1 divided by 12 divided by 2. Now come for C. C na D na? D. I can see a point martra D. So what is the previous iteration of D? 4 divided by 12. And outgoing of D is 1. You know very clear. That one day point martra C. So 1. Which is equal to 4.5 divided by 12. Okay. Now, PR of D. Let us calculate for D. D error point martra. I'm speaking English. Suddenly I come to Kannada. Because it's a second iteration. You have to understand this. If you doesn't understand second iteration, then there's no more iterations. Okay. So D ge error point martiradu, B martide, mathe C martide. So sum of B and C will be D. Sum of B andre eno, previous iteration of B divided by outgoing. Sum of C either C andre eno, previous iteration of C divided by outgoing. So B previous iteration eno, istide B do 2.5 divided by 12 plus B in the outgoing istide appa 1 do. One B in the outgoing one there. So similarly, when I come for D gain on point martyr the arrow C. C the previous iteration is to 4.5 divided by 12 divided by is to C outgoing. Nimig already got to obvious abuti the node in order. C the outgoing is to Muro. One because it is a node which is having highest outgoing. One do erado muro. So divided by 3, which is equal to 4 divided by 12. LCM la n beko adanella maadi 4 divided by 12. Aita iterations mugitu. Yarge highest ranking andre. Okay. If people can see. Okay. 1.5 divided by 12 is going to get the highest ranking. Next value just ide. When we divide. Inna mi baro anta value just ide. 2 divided by 12. Divide maadbeku. 1.5 in the 12 na divide maadidre just barutte. Okay, so 1.5 divided by 12 is going to become the first. Tumma kadame iradu madlu andre will be numerator nodi tumma kadame yavudide adu first barutte. Okay, so 1.5 divided by 12 is going to be assigned as a page rank 1. 2 by 12 is going to be assigned by page rank 2. 4 by 12 is going to assign by numerator nodkonde artha agibudute ellaadkinta kadame numerator yavudiradu 1.5 adu page rank 1. Okay na erneedu 2 adu page rank 2. Moorneedu 4 that is node D page rank 3. And C is nothing but highest greater. Okay, so greater, so 4.5. So 4. But you can see D is least actually, but it falls to the position number 3. Why? D yen ide D tumba least. ಅರ್ಥಾಗ್ತಿದ್ಯಾ ಡಿ ತುಂಬಾ ಲೀಸ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿದೆ ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ನೋಡಿ ಡಿಗೆ ವಿಸಿಟ್ ಮಾಡೋರೇ ಇಲ್ಲ ಡಿ ಔಟ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಎಷ್ಟು ಒಂದು ಡಿಗ್ ಇನ್ಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಎಷ್ಟು ಎರಡು ಬಟ್ ಆಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಸಿಗೆ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಔಟ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಇದೆ ಹಾಗೆ ಇನ್ಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಕೂಡ ಇದೆ ಇದು ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಅಲ್ವಾ ನೀವೇ ನೋಡಿದ್ರೇ ಹೇಳ್ಬೋದು ಸೊ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ಲಿ ಟೆಲ್ ಸೊ ಡಿ ಇಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ದ ಲೀಸ್ಟ್ ಔಟ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಇನ್ಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸಿ ಇಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ದ ಹೈಯೆಸ್ಟ್ ಔಟ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಇನ್ಕಮಿಂಗ್
then also C is standing at the place of 4 and D is standing at the place of 3. On what basis you are doing the page rank? Is your page rank is wrong? No. Here there is some logic. Okay. Why? Because very important website is pointing to D, not C. ಅರ್ಥ ಆಗ್ತಿದ್ಯಾ? ತುಂಬಾ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ವೆಬ್ಸೈಟ್ಸ್ ಬಿ ನೋಡಿ, ಎರಡನೇ ರ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿರೋ ವೆಬ್ಸೈಟ್ ಡಿ ಗೆ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಿದೆ, ಸಿ ಗೆ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಿಲ್ಲ. ಅಲ್ಲಿಗೆ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಡಿ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಪೇಜ್ ರ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಇವಾಗ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್, ಇಫ್ ಯು ಗಾಯ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಆಕ್ಸೆಸಿಂಗ್ ಸಮ್ ವಿ ಟಿ ಯು ವೆಬ್ಸೈಟ್, ಓಕೆ, ರಿಸಲ್ಟ್ ವೆಬ್ಸೈಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ದ ಹೈಯೆಸ್ಟ್ ರ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಎವ್ರಿಬಡಿ ಇಸ್ ಆಕ್ಸೆಸಿಂಗ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದೇರ್, ರೈಟ್ ಗಾಯ್ಸ್? ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಹೌ ದ ಪೇಜ್ ರ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಆಲ್ಗರಿದಮ್ ಇಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ವರ್ಕ್. ಯು ಕೆನಾಟ್ ಜಡ್ಜ್ ಬೈ ಸೀಯಿಂಗ್ ದ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್, ಯು ಶುಡ್ ಡೂ ದ ಕಾಂಪಿಟೇಷನ್. Because if you try to judge by seeing the page, you can say, sir, according to me, C is going to be in the first rank. But actually, C is going to be in the last rank. You should think this also, that important website is pointing to the website, which website it is pointing, that is going to get more rank. Because the competition of using that website is going to become very more. Because it is the one which is sharing the information, not the website which has been visited more. Okay. Did you understand? So this is how you need to solve for the 8 iterations. I think those who have attended my today's class, you can try out for the same. Believe that you should do the 8 iteration for the same competition. We have done for 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Another 4 you have to do, because we are starting from 0. So 0 to 7 iteration if you do, it's considered as a 8 iteration. And if you do this, pakka you can solve any problem in the given exam. Okay, very simple. The computation is very simple. You need to find out the page rank for the next iteration, which is equal to page rank of the given site in previous iteration divided by number of outgoing links. Okay, so you keep on doing. Now you very, very important thing is you should see which node is pointing to which node. If you take A, A is pointing by C. So only one node, so only one computation. When you go for B, B is getting pointed by two nodes, that is A and C. So sum of A and C will be B. When you go for C, C is getting pointed by two nodes, A and D. Sum of A and D will be C. So when you go for D, D is getting pointed by two nodes, B and C. Sum of B and sum of C will be D. When I say sum, sum is nothing but here page rank of given site in previous iteration divided by total number of outgoing links plus sum again, page rank of the given site in the previous iteration divided by total number of outgoing. Okay, na? So like this, you should try to find the outgoing links. So this question is very, very important to understand. You can see D is least actually, but it falls to the position number 3. Why? That's a very, very important question. Because very important website is pointing to D. Number 2 ranking website is pointing to D. Which is the number 2 ranking website? B. B is pointing to D. The value of D is going to get higher. So you cannot judge by seeing just incoming and outgoing nodes. You should do the computation. Then only you will get the proper results. Like this, if they have asked for 8 iteration, draw a plot of 8. If they ask for 3 iteration, draw a plot of 3. If they ask for 4 iteration, draw a plot of 4. And keep on working. Okay, so tomorrow I'm going to solve, show you one more problem, and you should solve with me on the screen so that the confidence of solving this problem gets higher, because it is the problem which has been asked in previous year question paper. Okay, it's a very, very important problem, page rank algorithm. I told you the question was for 8 iteration. Okay, those who are in my class, try to, after this classes, IoT and SMS class, try to do, continue the same iterations for 8 and try to give the page rank algorithm. Page ranking for all the 4 nodes. Okay, so any doubts, you can contact me at any point of time. So I think now GSSR will go in to take the class. Okay. Our SMS sir will come. Okay, any one class will be there. Any doubts in today's class, please, because this is a very, very important question. They have asked for 10 marks to 8 marks, and you can do it very easily. Why to write theory and get less marks when you're having such a easiest problem to solve and get more marks? Very easy problem, nothing more, simple mathematics. Any doubts? Speak up if anybody wants to speak. PR2, PR3, PR4, PR5 for all the nodes. Okay, up to 8. Any doubts? Okay, SMS class will be continued and just be online. I'm going to share sir as a host and I'm going to leave. Okay, so guys, please, any doubts, just tell me. This is a very, very important problem. We are going to discuss the same thing tomorrow. Okay, again, we are going to solve one more problem. And thank you.